Hey, what's up, guys? I've been helping an escape room lately with a little puzzle effect, and I have a blender. Let's talk about it. All right, so at some point through the progression of the escape room, we have this blender, right? And then there's a key in the blender, and you have to open a cabinet and get your hand in there to get a key out of there. Well, when you put your hand in there, you like trip these little limit switches, and then it turns on. Okay, that's not the plan. That plan got nixed. Here's the actual plan, though, since this is a bit too dangerous, I guess. Don't try this at home, guys. All right, although the sound of an actual blender turning on would be quite terrifying, for safety reasons, I went ahead and built this little sound module guy that triggers off of a PIR sensor here. But basically, this is more of an informational type video. I'll put probably a little schematic up at the end, just saying how I got this thing going, but these little soundboards are pretty cool. You can find them on Adafruit. Well, they're out of stock, but you can find them on DigiKey or Amazon. I'll throw some links down below or whatever. But essentially, yeah, there's no microcontrollers, no SD cards involved. You just plug this guy into your computer and you can drag and drop .ogg files or .wav files onto this guy. And depending on the file name you give it, like T01, T02, T03, etc., that assigns it to whatever pin you trigger on this guy. So you can load up to, I think, 11 different sound effects to trigger based on different inputs. And essentially you just take these buttons. When you push a push button, it triggers it to ground, or connects it to ground, which triggers that pin. But in my case, I got a little PIR passive infrared sensor hooked up, so when it senses movement, it'll trigger a sound. And I'll do a little demonstration real quick. So I'm perfectly still sneaking up. This would make like a good burglar alarm too, but speaker's all the way up and I move and then it doesn't work. What the heck is going on? Oh yeah, I guess I should probably plug in the speakers, shouldn't I? All right, winner, winner, chicken dinner. Wait till that red light goes off. That means that there's a sound playing. Turn the speakers on when that goes off and then be very still, pretend like we're a burglar. All right, we're a burglar. That was really scary. It's very scary still. Okay, we don't need you anymore. But yeah, it's very scary still and it's safe for commercial use, I guess. I don't know, guys. I'll put a little schematic like at the end of the video and show you how I got this wired up, because it's a little different. This board puts out a 3.3 volt signal off of its 11 pins, and this sensor basically triggers a 3.3 volt signal when it senses motion. So basically what I did is I hooked up a NPN transistor, so the NPN transistor triggers when my passive infrared module turns on, and it makes that connection to ground that the sound module pins require. I'll put some links down in the description for you guys, but short and sweet. See you next time. So just a few really quick tips about this project if you guys decide you want to do this project. I meant this to be a real quick and dirty how to get this guy working with this guy kind of video. I am going to put some really helpful links down in the description below if you want to look into these two boards and their capabilities and a little more information about them. There's lots of things you can do with both of these guys that I'm not covering here. But main tip for this guy, this soundboard here, if you're gonna plug it into a computer to put your sound files on this board here, make sure you're using a data capable micro USB cable. I went through like four micro USB cables wondering why my computer wasn't able to see this guy until I figured out that's what was going on. I had to get an actual data capable micro USB, because apparently I have a lot of them laying around that aren't data capable. These boards, there are a lot of different styles that you can find. There's like one version of them has this little stereo jack already built onto the board, and there's a board that has some amplifiers on it if you want to power some speakers just directly out the board. And they also have like a bigger 16 megabyte version of this board. 2 megabytes is not very much. That's all I needed for this guy, and this guy was actually available on Amazon, which is why I got that one. But
Yeah, that's it for that guy. One real quick tip. If you're like me and you like getting like cheap Chinese electronics off of Amazon, you might have found that you can't always trust the the pinouts. Like these the pinout they gave me on Amazon was not correct for these guys. And when I run into those situations, like I go down to the comments usually and just see what other people have figured out for these, and that's how I got the pinout for this. Somebody else said, "Hey, the pinout is not correct. This is the correct pinout," and lo and behold, that worked for me for these guys. But yeah, I don't trust the descriptions on Amazon. Kind of look in the comments and see what other people say. Last but most important tip, well, maybe most important, these PIR sensors, if you're going to use these, give them about 60 seconds when you power them up to adapt to the environment, because they do not work right in the first 60 seconds. They false trigger left and right, and they just, they're really goofy. It had me confused for a hot minute, because, yeah, you have to let them adapt to the environment before you expect them to work right, so give it about 60 seconds, but let's get back to the video and finish up, guys.
Also, for you guys that are like my little LED videos, if you caught my ant LED video that I made a while back, somebody asked me, well, how do I make the ants go backwards, go the opposite way? And I got it figured out, and I'm making a video about it as we speak. Well, I was making a video, then I get distracted by this project. But there's a video coming, guys, and we'll look at how to make the ants go the other way on our light strip. See you next time. This is Live Me Lightning, bring a little sound effect blender hand choppy choppy nonsense into your life. Woohoo!